First off, I want to start by just saying how much I loved watching your stories last week. That was one of my favorite lesson assignments to watch afterwards. So I didn't have time to comment on everybody's story. And I'm sorry, which is hard doing in person and virtual at the same time. But I did watch your stories. I watched every single one of them. And I really enjoyed it. So I loved how creative y'all got with the homemade instruments and homemade things. And then the stories themselves, it was really, really fun to watch. So thank you for blessing me with that this week. Now we're going to get started with our movement. We're going to do Wavin Flag. Have fun, y'all.
Rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day, we all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back. Give you freedom, give you fire, give you reason, take you higher. See the champions, take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets, our heads are lifting. Surrounds us, every nation all around us, singing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day, we all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back. Stronger, they'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes.
Hey kiddos, so this week you will be getting a music kit based on your grade level. They'll have different things based on your grade, and next week we're going to start using them in our lessons. So what you need to do first this week is to cut out the rhythm cards, so the notes. They'll have like whole notes and half notes and quarter notes and rests. So you just cut out on the gray line. So next week we can actually apply them. in our lesson. But I'm going to show you a little video that explains what all is in your grade level bag. And that way, whenever you get it, you'll understand what we're going to be doing with them. Okay, so check out this video.
Hi, third graders. I'm so excited to show you our new music kits. Every student is getting one, no matter if you're learning at school or at home. That way, everyone can participate in all of our activities. It's important that you take care of what you have in your music kit because it needs to last you through the whole school year. If you're at a desk or a table, you can keep your bag on it like mine is. Otherwise, it's okay to set your bag on the floor next to you. We're going to look at everything in our bags together. First, let's take out our rhythm sticks. Take yours out of the bag and put one in each hand, like this. Notice how I'm holding them almost at the bottom. See if your hands can look like mine. We'll call this the ready position. We can use these rhythm sticks to practice reading rhythms. Let's try some now. We'll see the rhythm and read it in our head. Then we'll echo by saying the rhythm syllables and playing our rhythm sticks. After each pattern, we'll put our sticks back in the ready position. Get ready to read. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta-di-ta-di-ta. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta-di-ta-ta. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta-ka-di-ni-ta-di-ta. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta-di-ta-ka-di-ni-ta. Ta-di-ta, ta-ka-di-ni-ta. Ta-di-ta-ka-di-ni-ta-ta. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta, ta-di-ta. Ta-ka-di-ni-ta, ta-ka-di-ni-ta. Great work reading rhythms. Remember, these rhythm sticks are a musical instrument, so we don't want to poke other people with them or throw them or hit them too hard. What family do they belong in? If you said percussion, you are correct, because we play them by hitting them together. Let's put these down and look at what's in our Ziploc bag. You have a paper with staff lines on it. It looks like this. And a little bag with circles and a piece of yarn. These are going to help us practice reading and writing notes on the staff. You also have a paper with boxes on it that looks like this. We'll use this one to practice writing rhythms. We have several pages of rhythm cards that we need to cut out, and you can do that after this video is over. You'll need to carefully cut on the gray lines. Some cards are bigger than others because those rhythms last longer. When you're finished cutting out your cards, you'll want to make sure that you throw away your trash. That's all of this on the outside that we don't need. Your smaller cards can go inside your empty Ziploc bag so that they don't get messed up. And then all of your papers can go back in your big Ziploc bag.
All right, today we're going to be talking about the music staff and reading notes and rests on it. Okay, so as you can see on the screen right now, we have five lines. These lines each have a name on the staff, and depending on where the note is on the staff, will tell you what to play or what to sing. All right, so first, we're going to have to add a clef to it. Now, the clef we're going to start with today is our treble clef. All right, whenever we add notes today, we're just going to be adding the note head, and that's what the note head looks like. It's an oval that's colored in today. Okay, and so we're not going to worry about the actual entire notes. We're just going to worry about the note head. That is a quarter note head. All right, so sometimes you'll see it on lines. Sometimes you'll see them on spaces.
And sometimes you'll see multiple. Whenever you read notes on the staff, you read from left to right, just like you would whenever you're reading words. So you start where the treble clef is, and then you go from there, you go to your right. All right. So let's start with our lines. So you always start at the bottom. Okay. You start down here at the bottom, and that is called E. This bottom line is called E. What is the next line called? G. Then you have B, D, and F. Now, how could we remember that? Because it's just random letters. Let's use this saying. Let me move my face a little bit. All right, let's use this saying. Every good boy deserves fudge. You know what fudge is? It's super good chocolate dessert. Really, really good, and it's even better with ice cream on it. So, all right, so we have every good boy deserves fudge. Can you say that with me? Every good boy deserves fudge. All right, so you start from the bottom, and the way you can remember this, we can use our hand because we have five fingers on our hand. So you start with your pinky, and be sure you're holding your hand sideways where your thumb's on top and your pinky's on bottom. Thumb's on top, kind of like you're scared and you want to cover your eyes because you're so scared. All right. So grab your pinky and say it with me. Each finger is a different letter. Every good boy deserves fudge. Do it again. Every good boy deserves fudge. There you go. Now you have E, G, B, D, F. You just have to remember the words and then think about the first letter of each word. Okay, you're taking that first letter of each word and you're applying it to the staff. So now, can you tell me what letter that is? Look for the red note head. You can start at the bottom. Every good what? Boy. B. Good job. Okay, every good boy. So that is a B. Very nice. What about this one? The top line. Start at the bottom and go, every good boy deserves what? Fudge, which starts with an F. Very good. All right, let's do another one. Okay, it's our bottom line. What does this phrase start with? Every. What letter? E. Very nice. Okay, what about this one? It's our fourth one. So every good boy what? Deserves D. That is a D. All right, and then we have our last one. Every what? Good. And don't forget, some people, for some reason, they go every boy, but not every boy, every good boy. They have to be good to deserve fudge. So you can't leave out that G, okay? All right, so those are our lines. Now we're going to move on to our spaces, and that is the space between the lines, the empty space. They have names too, because you can see notes all around on the staff. Okay, our bottom space is F, then A, then C, and then E. What does that spell? F, A, C, E. What does that spell? Face. It spells face. F, A, C, E, face. Can you say that with me? F, A, C, E, face. Okay. Now, let's use our hand. Okay, so you're going to put your finger between your other finger. So it goes F, A, C, E, face. All right, let's do it again. Ready? F, A, C, E, face. Very good. All right, so now let's see it on the screen. There's F, that's your first one. A, C, E space. And be sure you're going from the bottom up. On the staff, you read from the bottom up whenever you're doing your letters. Okay. All right. So S A C E space. All right. Now let's try different ones. Okay. So that is the third one. So spell face. We have F A. What is that? C, very good. So that is a C. What about this one? Our second one, so spell face. F, A, that's an A. Good job. What about our next one? Can you figure this out? Can you figure this one out on your own? Can you tell me what that is? If you guessed E, you're right, because it goes F, A, C, E. Very good. Now, what about this one? It's our first letter of face. What's the first letter of face? Face. Face. What does it start with? F. Very good. All right. Now we're going to combine lines and spaces together. Okay. It's getting a little complicated, a little hard, but that's okay. All right. So. Just use your hand. It helps a lot to use your hand. So we have every good boy deserves fudge. F A C E space. Okay. And remember, you always start from the bottom of your hand. Every good boy deserves fudge. F A C E space. Okay. All right. So let's test our knowledge. What is that? Is that a line or a space? It looks like it's not a line, so you have to do every good boy deserves fudge. So let's do it together. Every good what? Boy, B, very nice. Okay, let's try another one. All right, it's a space. So what do we spell? What rhymes with space? Face. All right, so what is that? That is the first letter of face. What would that be? F A C E face. So that is F. Nice. Okay, what about this one? This is our line and it's on top, so it's the last letter. So every good boy deserves what? Fudge. F. Good job. Now, I thought we just had an F before this. Was this F too? It was. So what's the difference between these two? They're both F, but one is a space and one is a line. We have a space on bottom and we have a line on top and they're both F. So which one do you think is called high F? This one or this one? Which one's higher up on the staff? I say the line F is higher. So that is high F. And then we have low F. That is space F and line F. Okay? All right. What is this? This is the third space, so what do we spell? Face, third letter of face. F, oh, wrong side. F, A, C, very good. C, okay, what about this one? Our second line, every what? Every good, G, very good. All right, then we have our top space. Spell face. F A C. What is that? E. Very good. All right, last one. First line. Every good boy deserves fudge. What's the first letter of that? E for every. Very good. But didn't we have another E right before this? Yes, we had another E. So this is the same as the F. We have two F's and two E's. We have a line E and we have a space E. Okay, so there's your line E. There's your space E. Which one is higher? The space E is higher. So that's high E and low E. High E and low E. All right, so that is what it looks like. And sometimes, whenever you can have multiple notes, most of the time, you'll have multiple notes on the staff. So like this, how do you know which one to do first? I think I said at the beginning, you read going left to right. Okay, so you start at the treble clef over here, and you move to your right. So which one do we hit first? This one right here. So what letter is that? It's a space, so what do you spell? What rhymes with space? Face. So what's the first letter of face? F. Then the next one we hit is up here, whenever you're going across. What letter is that? That's our last letter of face, because it goes F, A, C, E, face. So that is an E. So far we have F, E, and then we have a line. So we have to do our every good boy deserves fudge. Every good boy, what is this? Deserves, D. So we have F, E, D. What does that spell? Fed, like you fed the dog. F, E, D, fed. Let's do another one. Okay, so we have a line. Actually, all of these are lines. So all you need to remember is every good boy deserves fudge. So you start by the treble clef and go across. So first one we hit is every good what? Boy, B. Very nice. So there's a B. What is this one? It's your first letter. Every E. And then every good boy deserves. So B, E, D. What does that spell? Bed, like I went to bed. All right. We'll do another one. What about this one? This has a space at the beginning. So we have to spell face. F, A, C, what? E, very nice. So we have E, and then we have a line right here. So what line is that? Every good boy deserves. So we have E, D, then what's next? Can you tell me what that is? Every good. So E, D, G, and now our last one. It's the first letter of the line. Every, and what letter is that? E. So if we put that all together, it's E, D, G, E spells edge. Like the edge of a cliff. You don't want to go there. Edge, edge, E, D, G, E. All right, last one. Let's see if you can figure this one out by yourself. Start with this one and then go across. All right, did you figure it out? All right, so let's start with this one. Every good boy, B. Then we have a space, so we got to spell face. F, A, C, E. So far we have B, E. Then we have another space, so we got to spell face. F, A, B, E, A. And then we have a line, so we got to do every good boy deserves fudge. Every good boy deserves B-E-A-D. D spells bead, like the beads on my necklace, the bead. Very good. Nice. So whenever you have them all in a row going up together, that is called a scale. All right. So we have from the bottom all the way up to the top. And this is what it looks like. This is what the letters, whenever you put it all together in sync like this, that's what it looks like. E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F. And it just keeps on going. And it's kind of like the alphabet, except the music alphabet only has A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And then it repeats itself over and over. So it's A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So if you start with, let's say in this case, we started with an E, so it'd be E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, and this repeats itself. But a lot of the time, scales start on C. So let me move my face over. They start on C. So that requires ledger lines. Now, ledger lines, you see these extra lines that are going below and above the staff up here? They're called ledger lines. And that's whenever you go above the staff or below, then you have to use these little ledger lines for each note. And that will help you connect it together. So it just keeps on going. So down below the staff, what letter is in front of E in the alphabet? D, right? And so that's D, the space right below. And then if you keep the lines going, the lines and spaces going, then you have a C right in front of D. And then if you go after, so it goes F, and then in the alphabet, what's after F? Then G, and then it starts over, A, and it keeps going up and up and up. So you could have a lot of ledger lines going up. But in elementary, we're not going to do much with ledger lines except for these right here, these two, one bit below and one above. Okay? So you did awesome. That is the lines and spaces of the treble clef staff, which treble clef means the higher up note. Okay? Bass clef is the low note. Treble clef is the high note. All right? So I hope you learned something. Now I would like for you to go and take your lines and spaces quiz. All right? All right, so be sure to go to that link, and then after you finish, click mark as done on your assignment. All right? Great job, guys. Bye.
Please remind your parents to pick up your music kit from MES during one of the following times: Monday, November 2nd, between 3:30 and 4:30, or Thursday, November 5th, between 5 and 6 p.m.